お待たせいたしました。本日のプレスブリーフィングを始めます。
Good afternoon and thank you very much for waiting. We'd like to now begin the press briefing.
育児と仕事を両立する環境づくりが急務となる中、ワークライフバランスの取り組みが日本の企業や省庁に広がっています。政府も女性の活躍推進に向けた取り組みを強化しており、明日と明後日には2回目となる女性が輝く社会に向けた国際シンポジウム、略称ワウを開催いたします。
In view of the urgent need for creating an environment where the child rearing and work are compatible, the Japanese enterprises as well as the government agencies and ministries are currently promoting the work-life balance related initiatives. And the central government is also working on initiatives to promote to induce more active roles to be performed by women, and that for tomorrow and the day after tomorrrow,The government will host the World Assembly for Women in Tokyo, or WOW.
そこで本日は株式会社ワークライフバランスの小室義恵代表取締役社長をお招きし、数多くの企業へのコンサルティングのご経験を踏まえた日本のワークライフバランスの現状と課題、提言等についてお話を伺います。
Thus, we invited Ms. Yoshie Komuro, President of Work Life Balance today, to ask her.To share her comments and observations based upon her rich experience in consulting to Japanese enterprises and businesses about where we stand in terms of the work-life balance in Japan, the challenges as well as recommendations, advice.
小室社長は資生堂在職中、育児休業者の職場復帰支援サービス事業を立ち上げて注目され、2006年にワークライフバランスを設立されました。現在は産業競争力会議とさまざまな政府の委員等のメンバーとして積極的に発言されており、先ほどご紹介した WOW にも参加される予定です。
And Ms. Komuro, when she was working for Shiseido, launched the project to support the mothers' return to work after maternity leave, and that attracted a lot of interest and attention. And in 2006, she established work-life balanceAnd nowadays, she is a member of various government hosting organizations, committees, including Council for Industrial Competitiveness, and that she plans to attend WOW, the World Assembly for Women in Tokyo that I introduced earlier.
Now, 本日はすでにご案内の通り、写真撮影のお時間を小室様のご説明の冒頭 2、3 分、および質疑応答の冒頭 2、3 分の2回に限らせていただきます。それ以外の時間帯の撮影はお控えください。また撮影場所も会場後方の左右に限らせていただきますので、ご協力をお願いいたします。
I'd like to remind you that as has been announced previously, at this time the photo taking opportunities are twice. That is, the first 2-3 minutes of the presentation by Ms. Komuro, and then first 2-3 minutes of the Q&A session. So please refrain from taking photos for the rest of the hoursAnd also, I'd like to remind you that the photo taking could be only made from either the left or right of the back of the room, and I ask for your cooperation.
本日の通訳者は株式会社リンガバンクの添田よしこさんです。
Interpreter today is Yoshiko Soeda from Linga Bank.
皆様には携帯電話をマナーモードにしていただきますようご協力をお願いいたします。
Now, I'd like to ask you once again to make sure that the smartphones and cell phones are switched to the silent mode.
それでは小室様、お願いいたします。
Yes, now, Ms. Komuro, your audience.
皆さん、こんにちは。紹介いただきましたワークライフバランスの小室です。今日はワークライフバランスが日本を変えるということで、ワークライフバランスの現状と展望についてお話ししたいと思います。
Well, good afternoon and thank you for the kind introduction. My name is Komuro of the Work-Life Balance. Today I'd like to talk about how the work-life balance will change Japanese societies, including where we stand in terms of work-life balance as well as the future outlook.
先ほどご紹介いただきましたが、私の、会社の本業はですね、企業の残業を減らして業績を上げるというコンサルティングを今まで900社以上に提供してきています。
And as has been introduced, our company is engaged in consulting business for more than 900 companies and enterprises so far. And the gist of the consulting is how they can improve productivity while reducing the overtime work.
2006年に起業した時には、こうした仕事が、黒字になるとは自分たちでも予想していなかったんですが、結果としては現在ですね、この創業して9年間、ずっと増収増益で、現在はとにかくもう企業からのご依頼が多すぎて、お受けしきれないというぐらい残業を減らしたいというようなご依頼が急増しているような状況です。
Back in 2006, when we started a company, we were not sure whether this kind of consulting business can make profit forever. And however, for the past 9 years during our operation, we have witnessed the increase in both the revenue as well as income. And nowadays, we sometimes have to turn down the request by the companies for offering consulting, indicating that there is a strong desire on the part of Japanese companies to reduce overtime job.
2012年に、国会に呼ばれてですね、この国の労働時間に対して、どういったその政策が必要かということをプレゼンテーションしたのをきっかけに、昨年9月から安倍内閣の産業競争力会議のメンバーとなり、長時間労働の是正が経済にどういった影響を与えるのかというようなことを主に提言してきています。
And in 2012, I was invited to speak at the Diet Committee regarding the policies related to the working hours. And as a result, or probably because that triggered the increasing interest, ever since I have been involved in various activities, including the participation in the Industrial Competitiveness Council in September last year, the council that is organized by Abe Cabinet, discuss what kind of impact could be the felt on the part of economy as a result of the long working hours.
で、正直言いまして、昨年まではそういった提言をすることがあまり求められていない、反応があまり良くないという実感を、政府に対して私は持っていたんですけれども、明らかに昨年末ぐらいから、長時間労働の是正という話題に対して大変政府が積極的に、また私の提言に関しても重要な、提言書の中に、政府の発行するものの中に、何ページも割かれて入ってくるというような大きな変化を感じています。
And frankly speaking, up until last yearI felt somewhat a tepid reaction and response on the part of the government, even when I presented my recommendations and advice. However, since the end of last year, I started to feel some clear difference on the part of the government. And now that my recommendation about how companies or organizations can reduce long working hours,that kind of recommendation is now reflected in the reports issued by the government that indicates the rising interest on the part of the government.
そこで提言してきた内容を今日は皆さんにお伝えしたいと思っております。
And today I'd like to share with you some of the advice and recommendation that I offer to the government and those concerned.
まず現状なんですけれども、こちら見ていただきますと、週50時間以上残業している人の割合というのは、実は世界で日本が一番多いという状況にあります。
First, about the reality. In fact, Japan is a country where the largest number of people have to work the 50 hours or longer, and that is the largest number of the population among the countries in the world.
またワークライフバランスに関する満足度も24カ国の中で最も低いという現状です。
Well, as in the case of the satisfaction on the work-life balance, in fact, the Japan is lowest among 24 countries.
ところが、それだけ労働に時間をかけている国での、では成果の方はどうかというのが次のスライドになります。
Now, next slide shows the result, the outcome, as a result of working so many hours.
これは労働生産性で表したグラフですけれども、OECD34 カ国中で日本は22位、これは先進国だと20年間連続で最下位ということになります。
Well, among the 34 OECD member countries, in terms of the labor productivity, Japan is ranked 22nd. And among advanced economies, Japan is lowest in terms of ranking for the past 20 consecutive years.
つまり一言で言うと、一番時間をかけていて、生み出す付加価値が一番低い国という状態かと思います。
That means Japan is a country where the employees work longest the hours with the smallest or least productivity.
このことで、現在企業に起きていることは、労働時間が、睡眠や私生活を圧迫するので、日中の集中力も低く、またアウトプットに必要な、アイディア、のインプットする時間がないということで、労働時間が、増えれば増えるほど生産性が低くなるというような負のスパイラルに陥っているというのが現状の日本かと思います。
Now, as a result, what the company's experience is that because the people have to work so many hours, sometimes they have to sacrifice their hours for relaxation, including sleep, and therefore they can't concentrate when they should during the daytime, where they can't spare time for study, that is, to gain more input for generating more ideas. Thus, despite longer working hours, the lower productivity, that's what is experienced, resulting in the vicious cycle.
ここからは、この状態の、まま、一体日本社会がどういうふうになるのか、で現在舵を切って変化すると、どういう社会になるのか、2つのパターンのシミュレーションをお見せしたいと思います。
Now let's take a look at the two simulation studies. One, if business as usual is maintained, what happens to Japan? And the second, if what if Japan changes its direction? What could be the consequence?
まず、今まで通りだった場合なんですけれども、
First, in the case of business as usual scenario.
このスライドの左側にある大きな塊が一つの企業だと思ってください。
On the left, there is a big square that represents one company.
青い部分が、1日の8時間以内の労働で、黄色い部分が残業時間を示します。
Blue represents working hours, that is 8 hours or less per day, and then the yellow, that represents overtime work.
今までの経営者は、固定費を下げてコストを下げようということで、コスト削減の際に真っ先に赤い点線の枠内に注目をする、つまり、リストラというようなことをずっとやってきました。
And now, on the part of the management, in order to improve business, the out of effort to reduce fixed expenses, that is to lower the cost. They first took a look at the area that is surrounded by the red dotted line, that is restructuring.
しかし、人を削減した分の仕事を、削減するということをしませんので、その状態のまま今度は右の、ような、図式の状態になります。
However, even when the number of the people is reduced,The amount of workload is not reduced, and therefore, what happens to the company? That's what is represented on the right.
削減した固定費よりも一番上の緑色の部分ですが、残業代がむしろ上増してしまうというような現象であったり。
So as a result, compared to what was reduced in terms of the fixed the cost, the payment for the overtime work that is represented in yellow.Would be more than what was reduced.
メンタル疾患の増加によるリスクの増加や優秀な人材の流出、それから育児女性が辞めてしまうというそれまでかけた育成費のロスなどが起きています。
And, and then there could be the risk of the mental illness because employees are so exhausted and therefore they would be eventually leaving the companies or.Those mothers bore a birth to the child, they would eventually leave the company, and that resulted in the lost the expenses investment made in the past to develop those personnel.
この状態がさらに今もう一つ深刻な段階に入り始めています。
And in fact, we are now looking at the aggravation of that situation.
先ほど右側にあった図が今回のスライドでは左側にあります。
What was seen on the right in the previous screen is now on the left.
でそこから時間が経過して右側のような状態に移ってきているんですが、まず一つ介護という大きな問題が出てきています。
That is to say, as time elapsed, the square in or the box in the left is now evolving into what is represented on the right, and there is additional problem that is about the nursing of elderly.
介護の問題の場合、管理職の男性というような今まで会社を休んだり辞めたりすることはないと思われていた、365日仕事ができると思われていたような人が休む、辞めるというような状態が企業に衝撃を与えています。
As a result of the need for nursing or taking care of elderly parents, that resulted in unexpected the consequenceThat is to say, those middle management, the male that used to be considered as those that will be working 7/24 and they will never leave the company or they never take leave. And in fact, they are now taking the leave to take care of their parents or sometimes they quit or resign.
その、抜けた分の仕事を誰かがフォローしようと、誰かにフォローしてもらおうとしても、この状態ですでに先に人を削減してしまっていますので、フォローできるようなまず余裕がないという状態になっています。
So that the vacuum has to be made up for by somebody else to follow up. However, remember that this company already reduced the number of headcounts and therefore there are no employees that are capable of occupying that vacuum left by the employees that left the company.
かつ今労働力人口が少なくなっている日本では労働環境が悪い、こういった長時間労働で人が少ないような企業にはますます優秀な人材が集まらないという形になり、どんどんと事業継続が不可能になるというような形で転がり落ちていっています。
And in, on top of that, now that the productive population is declining, if it is a company with a poor working environment where employees have to work many hours, the management can't find qualified people to fill the vacuum or the vacancies left by the people left the company. And therefore, as a result, they cannot fill up the vacancies. As a result, the business performance would worsen and worsen.
実際に、日本ではブラック企業とよく言われるんですが、労働環境が悪いというようなことが、有名になった企業では、近年ですね、相次いで、赤字に転落するというような企業が出てきています。
Well, that is typical of what is called the black companies, quote unquote. That's the company that are notorious for the poor working environment, and therefore, we are seeing that many of those black companies are now suffering in red.
今2つ目のシミュレーションに入りたいんですけれども、
Now, what if something is different? This is a second scenario.
左側にある図は先ほどあったものと一緒なんですが、逆転の発想の経営者が注目をするのは黄色い部分になります。
What is the depicted on the left remain the same as the one that we saw in the earlier slide. HoweverNow, this is a company under the management with the mindset that is radically changed. Now, they look at what is highlighted in yellow.
で、この黄色い部分の、いわゆる残業時間の部分を、いかにして削減するかということに成功した企業が、右側の図にあるように、その減らした分のコストで、時間には制約があるけれども、能力が高いというような社員を積極的に雇用し始めています。
And if company succeeds in reducing the overtime work, they are now successfully reducing the cost, and at the same time, they are successfully hiring those highly qualified people that have a constraint in terms of the working hours.
今まで日本企業では時間に制約がある人材というのはいかに能力が高くても使いづらいという理由で採用しないという企業が大変多かったんですけれども、働き方の方を変えることによって能力が優秀であればというふうに、取れる人材の幅が非常に広がってきたということが言えます。
Conventionally, in Japan, those people that have a high quality yet having the time constraint were considered to be the least conducive for the company hiring, and therefore the many companies were not willing to hire those people. However, nowadays, by changing the way of working, those highly qualified people with time constraint could be the new supply of workforce.
例えば大阪厚生病院という病院があるんですけれども、そこでは時間に制約がある医師、女性の医師などでも、全くこう関係ないということで、6割ほど医師や看護師を増やしました。でそうしたところ、一人一人の時間が短くなって、で、人数は増えたんですけれども、そういった短い時間の優秀な医師をたくさん集めることができて、現在は取り組み前の3倍の利益、8億円に上っています。
For instance, in the case of Osaka Kosei Hospital or Welfare Hospital, in their case, they decided to hire those the doctors, especially women, who have a time constraint with high quality. And in fact, they increased the headcounts of doctors, physicians, and nurses by 60%. And yet, with more doctors and nurses that are highly qualified who would work for the shorter period of time, with that,They increased the profit by three times to 800 million yen.
こうした戦略を取った企業は、さらに勝てる仕組みに入ってきています。先ほどのスライドで右側にあった図が今度は左側にあります。
And those companies that successfully introduced such a strategic initiative is now establishing their winning formula, the victory formula, so to speak.So now on this slide, what is on the left is what was on the right in the earlier slide.
この右側を見ていただきたいんですが、実際に介護で離職するような人がいても、先ほどの病院の例のように頭数を増やしてあることによって、お互いの仕事の、フォローが非常に容易になっている。また、育児や介護が理由で辞める人が激減して、ノウハウがきちんと定着をしてミスが少なくなってきているというような成果が出てきています。
That is to say, such company that was introduced in the previous slide is now evolving into the next step, which is on the right-hand side of this slide. That means even when there are those people who have to leave the company's organizations because of the need for nursing their parents, for instance, like in the case of earlier hospital, they already hired more people so that the vacancies or vacuum left by such people could be easily filled.With more people. And with that, they are now seeing less people that are leaving the company's organizations due to the need for childcare or the nursing of their parents. And with that, at the same time, the expertise that have been accumulated in the organization have increased with less the errors.
こうした2つのシミュレーションのどちらのタイプの企業が増えるのかによって、この国の財政に大きな影響があります。
And now, after taking a look at those two simulations, depending on which type of the companies would increase in Japan, that can also affect the economy of Japan.
この話は実際に2012年に、国会で、国会に呼ばれて、した時のスライドをそのまま持ってきたものです。
Well, this is a slide that I used for presentation at the Diet when I was invited there in 2012.
まず前者のような企業ばかり、今のまま現状のままの企業が日本社会に増えた場合のシミュレーションになります。
First, this is a simulation when the first the category of the companies that is business as usual type of the companies. What if those companies increase? Then this is what we will see.
まず右上の吹き出しですが、介護の問題です。
The first the bubble on the top that represents the problem related to nursing need for parents.
介護の問題は、家族が24時間型で仕事をしていると、まだ低い要介護度であるときから24時間型の施設に預け入れようとする、そのことによって政府としては24時間型施設を大量に作らなくてはならない、つまり非常に財政にダメージがあります。
In this case, when the family members seek to work for 24 hours around the clock to support the family members and to take care of the elderly, and then even when the need for the nursing is rather low, they seek for facilities, the hospitals or nursing homes that take care of those the elderly, and therefore there will be the rising need for such facilities. That means more spending by the government.
2つ目が保育の問題で、日本は夫婦ともに長時間労働の場合、保育園の延長保育を非常に使うようになります。この延長保育が保育園の赤字となり、この赤字は日本では各都道府県の自治体にすべて、かかる形になりますので、自治体の財政を圧迫する形になります。
The second case has to do with the child care. If there are two bread earners in the householdAnd if they work for long hours, then they seek for the daycare center that can take care of their children in the after hours. And therefore, that results in more costs and expenditures by such daycare centers and the nursing schools. As a result, such deficit would be passed to the local governments, municipalities, so their burden would increase.
また下から2つ目ですけれども、これは女性が仕事と育児を両立できなかった場合、仕事を辞めることによって将来の年金が少なくなるということで、子人に対して手当を増額するような要求に、育児手当を増額するような要求につながったり、将来生活保護の対象になる女性が大量に出るであろうというふうに言われています。
And now another example, that's the second from the bottom. In this case, this has to do with womenwho have to quit the job because they could not then make it compatible with the child care. In such a case, in the future, they will receive less pension, and therefore they will call for more allowance for instance, for child care. And also they might need for allowance to support their livelihood in the future. And there will be the large number of such women in the future.
つまり企業の労働時間というのは企業の自由であるというふうに今までの政府は思ってきたんですが、実は企業の労働時間が長くなると国の財政に大きな影響が出るんだということをやっと理解し始めているということです。
The conventionally, government used to think that it is up to the discretion of the companies to determine the working hours of employees, and therefore they didn't care. However, nowadays they realize thatThe longer working hours could eventually turn out into increasing burden for the finances of the government.
これが労働時間を減らした場合、日本の残業問題が改善した場合の財政への影響です。
Now, what if the working hours are reduced with less overtime work?
右上にあるように介護の問題、これから2017年になりますと団塊世代が一斉に70代に入ることで問題は非常に大きくなるんですが、家族が残業せずに家に帰ることができれば、24時間型の施設ではなく家庭で介護と仕事をこう両立していくようなモデルが実現可能だと言われています。
On the top on the right, that is about the nursingIt is said that by 2017, the baby boomers will turn into 70s in their age, and therefore that is considered as potential major problem. However, if the situation is changed as such, then the family members don't have to work for overtime, and they don't have to seek for the facilities that can take care of their parents around the clock, and therefore instead,they can support their elderly at home.
また先ほどの保育の問題も、夫婦の残業が少なければ、延長保育を使うことなく、夫婦が迎えに行けるということで、一番下に書いたように定時後の時間で、育児介護健康維持地域活性化というようなことを個人が、自分の不安ごとに自分で対策ができる社会という、つまりあまり財政を使わない社会の実現をすることができると言えます。
And also in the case of the child care, if parents don't have to work for extra hours, then they don't have to have their children accommodated by the extended hours or extra hours at the daycare center. And therefore, they can achieve and take control of the child care, the domestic affairs, the health care, and also the revitalizing the local economies eventually, and therefore in such circumstances it will require less the financing or spending by the government.
そのことをプレゼンをして私が提言したのがこちらのスライドになります。
And in that presentation I gave to the Diet, the after stating what I have just introduced, this is the gist of the recommendation that I presented.
一つ目が長時間労働をさせる企業が損をする仕組みをいかに作るかという点で、日本の残業代というのは残業代の割増率はまだ 1.25 倍です。でこれは世界の中では大変低い水準であり、これをもっと上増していくべきであるというのが1点目でした。
First, how we can create a system where the companies that let employees work extra hours would eventually suffer loss. So as a part of such a mechanism, we can think of the premium that is paid for overtime workIn Japan, the premium is 1.25 times for extra hours that employees work. And compared to the global standard, that is rather low, and therefore, this could be further raised.
で、このことは、今、60時間を超えた場合、残業時間が60時間を超えた場合、中小企業も含めて 1.5 倍というふうに、以前よりも割増の率が大きく、変化しました。
And in fact, the change was introduced so that when the overtime work exceeds 60 hours, then including small and medium-sized enterprises, they have to pay 1.5 times more as the hourly the payment as a premium, and therefore the situation has changed.
二つ目に、企業の労働時間を短くした上で、若者や子育て女性がきちんと働ける環境が整備されていなくては、右の下にあるように新しい労働力が招き入れられないので、この特に待機児童に対する保育所の整備をしていくようにということを提言しました。
And secondly, even when the working hours are reduced, do we have to create an environment how we can mobilize the youth, young people as well as women, and as the concrete measuresI recommended that the government should work on the initiatives to increase the child care centers and reduce the child care waiting list or eliminate the waiting list.
このことも実はこの2年で大きな変化をしました。
And on this front as well, we saw major changes in the past two years.
実は私は政府の委員を10年間やってきて、そのうち前半の8年は待機児童問題を訴えても対策が全く取られなかったんですが、この2年、なんと 0.7 兆円の予算がついて、保育所の数は20万人分増えたというような変化がありました。
Well, I have been serving in the government committee for the past 10 years, but for the first 8 years, even when I called for the measures to eliminate the child care waiting list, no measures were taken whatsoever. However, in the past 2 years, the government increased the budget for establishing more daycare centers.With 0.7 trillion yen, and now that with that extra spending, the facilities to accommodate 200,000 children are now made available.
下の資格の中にまとめましたが、政府はこれまでは労働時間の問題は個別の企業の問題というふうに放置してきた。また労働時間を管理しないで済む方が日本の経済は発展するんだというふうに過去は思ってきました。
Well, and as a conclusion, as is stated in the box in the bottom of the page, for the government, conventionally, they used to think that the working hours and the questions or the issues related to it are the matters of the individual companies, and therefore they have not intervened anything in terms of such working hours. And also, they thought that was better for the Japanese economy if there is no management or control that is in place.For the working hours.
そうした大きな政策の転換が分かりやすいのが、今年の6月30日に出された日本最高戦略ですけれども、ここの14ページ、英語版だと12ページなんですけれども、そこに長時間労働の是正は経済成長に大きな効果をもたらすというふうに記載され、今までの福祉の観点ではなく、成長戦略というような取り組みの文脈で書かれるというふうに大きな変化をしました。
And that is such a major change by the government policies is now reflected in, for instance, in the Japan revitalization strategy that was published on June the 30th. The, on Japanese version, page 14, and in English version, it's on page 12. Now, according to that report, they now consider that the reducing or rectifying the working hours is good for the growth of the economy, and therefore, the matters related to working hours are now viewed in the context of the economic growth rather than welfare.
でここからは、日本の企業の経営者が、どういった発想の転換を始めたかという話をしたいと思います。
And from here on, I'd like to talk about the change on the part of the mindset of the management of the companies.
今私は年間200回ぐらい講演会の依頼を企業からいただいているんですが、その7割ぐらいはここからお話しする、人口ボーナス期とオーナス期という話について、ま、企業の役員会議などで説明をしてほしいという依頼が多いです。
Well, typically, I receive about 200 requests of, a year for talking in front of the top management of the companies. And 70% of those invitations have to do with the topic, what is termed as the population bonus versus population onus. And that kind of presentation is typically given to the board of directors or the top management of the companies.
少しこの人口ボーナス、オーナスという話を皆さんにもご説明したいんですけれども、人口ボーナス期というのは、これハーバード大学のデイビッド・ブルームが、非常に分かりやすく提唱して、認知度が上がってきている考え方です。
I'd like to briefly talk about what is this population bonus and onus are about. And in fact, this was advocated by David Bloom of Harvard University, and that interest has been rising ever since.
人口ボーナス期の国というのは若者の割合が多く、まあ、労働力の割合が多く、高齢者が少ししかいないという人口比率の時期であり、この時期の国は安い労働力を武器に、まあ、社会保障費、高齢者が少ないことで社会保障費がかさまず爆発的な経済発展をする、することが多いというふうに言われています。
The countries in, during the population bonus era are typicallyThe ones where the young population as well as the productive population are more with fewer elderly, and therefore they can mobilize the cheap labor while paying less for the welfare for the elderly, and therefore those countries typically achieve high economic growth.
現在人口ボーナス期に入っているのが中国、韓国、シンガポールやタイだと言われていて、日本は60年代の半ばから90年代の半ばですでに人口ボーナス期が終了しています。
The countries that are currently in the population bonus are China, Korea, Singapore, and Thailand, well as in the case of Japan, that's back in years ago, that is from the mid-1960s to mid-1990s.
この人口ボーナス期は一度終わった国には人口ボーナス期が終わった国には二度と訪れないというふうに言われています。
And once the population bonus era is over, then that country would never experience again the bonus era or period.
これは経済成長することで富裕層が教育投資をし、それによって高学歴化、そのことにより人件費も上昇し少子化になる。また医療が充実することで高齢者が寿命を伸ばし、その高齢者の比率が高まることで社会保障費が非常に重くなってくるからだというふうに言われています。
According to the explanation, it states that as a result of economic growth, there will be more the high income bracket, the high income population in the, that country, and therefore they would spend more for educationAnd therefore, that would become the society with high academic career, and therefore that results in higher labor expenses with fewer children born. And at the same time, elderly would live longer, meaning that they require more welfare expenditures.
右下のグラフを見ていただくと分かりますように、日本は、もう人口ボーナス期が終わって20年経った状態、人口オーナス期という時期にすでに入っています。
Therefore, as is indicated on the graph on the right bottom, Japan has experienced 20 years after the population bonus period it was over, and now Japan is in the population onus era.
この人口オーナス期は人口構造がその国に対その国の経済に対して重荷になる時期というような時期です。
And under population onus period, the demography or demographic structure of that country would become increasing burden for the economy of that country.
働く人口よりも支えられる側の人口の方が多くなる状況になります。真ん中の、パラグラフにあるように、人口オーナス期になった国では、労働力人口の減少と働く世代が引退世代を支える社会保障制度の維持困難が、起きると言われています。
That means those are the productive population have to support the larger number of the people that require care and nursing, and therefore under the population onus era, there will be declining the working population, and therefore the fewer working population have to support more the people that require care, and therefore the welfare system and social security system are hard to be maintained.
日本はこの先ほどのボーナス期からオーナス期に移行するのが世界の中でも非常に早く進んだと言われています。それはなぜかというと、少子化対策に失敗したことによって高齢化の率が急速に高まってしまったということが大きな要因です。
In the case of Japan, it is said that transition from bonus to onus has been extremely fast compared to the rest of the world. That is because of the failure in implementing effective measures against the lower birth rate, and that the aging society has accelerated.
なぜ日本がこんなにも早く、少子化になり、高齢化比率が上がってしまったのか、少子化対策に失敗した要因というのは下に挙げた2つになります。
And you might ask why Japan failed in the countermeasures against the low birth rate and the working against the aging society. The reasons are stated in the bottom of the page.
1つ目は政府の方の、待機児童対策の遅れです。これによって働く女性が子どもを産むとそのまま労働力から弾き出される、つまり現在の労働力が常に減り続けてしまう構造を固定化したということになります。
That is, there more specifically, government failed to implement measures to eliminate the waiting list for child care, and as a result, the women employees, once they gave birth to their children, then they havenor no other choice but to retire, and therefore they constantly left the workforce, meaning that the workforce continued to decline, and such the structure or mechanism was established and they didn't improve.
もう一つは企業の働き方が要因でした。長時間労働の職場で女性が働こうとしたときに、そこで認められるためには産むことをやめるというような選択をした女性が増えました。
Another had to do with the working style at the companies in Japan. In the companies or the offices where the employees expected to work for extra hours, for women to be recognized as valid or significant the workforce, they had to give up giving a birth to children, and therefore more womenDecided not to have babies or children.
こういったことによって急速に労働力が減り、高齢化が進んだ結果、人口オーナス期に、非常に早いタイミングで入ってしまったというのが現状の日本です。
As the workforce continued to decline, at the same time when the aging society has increasingly advanced, as a result,transition to onus, the population onus period in Japan was accelerated.
この人口ボーナス期とオーナス期で経済成長するルールというのが全く違うので、今日本に求められているのはボーナス期で大成功したこの成功体験を捨ててオーナス期に成功できるルールにどれだけ早く切り替えられるかというところです。
And whether it is the population bonus countries or the countries with the population onus, the success or the rules for the economic the growth are quite different, and therefore for Japan, what is required is to forget about their success or story in the past during the population bonus period, and then how Japan can quickly shift to the economic growth strategy under population onus period.
次のスライドにボーナス期とオーナス期の経済発展しやすいルールの違いを求めました。
This slide summarizes the differences in terms of the rules and working styles, whether it is under population bonus or population onus.
まずボーナス期ですが、少し端的すぎる言い方かもしれませんが、なるべく男性ばかりで、なるべく長時間働いた企業が勝ちます。
This may be a too much simplification, but in the case of the population bonus period, the winners are those companiesthat mobilize more men, let them work more hours, and then they would win or succeed.
この時期の経済は重工業に支えられていることや、早く大量に市場にサービスを出すということが大きな成果に直結するからです。
That is because during that time, typically economy is supported by the heavy industry, and therefore, and at the same time, that is a time when the mass productionas expeditiously promoted as possible is what is required.
そしてもう一つが、なるべく同じ条件の均一な人材を揃えることです。
And another condition during that time has to do with how they can acquire homogeneous workforce.
そしてこれが日本はこのことを達成するために特殊な、働くルールを作りました。
And to, fulfill those conditions in Japan, a very special set of rules were established.
それは、本人にとって少し辛い転勤であったり、残業であったり、出張であったりというようなものを、必要以上に課すことによって、それに振るい落とされないように頑張った人だけが昇進できるというような、仕組みです。
That is, there could be some, the orders or the requests by the company to the employee per se, that is the request for the moving to different location or request for working more hours or the business trip that he doesn't want to take. And when those requirements are placed on the employees more than necessary, and then only those the met such requirement could be only promoted, and such structure was created.
これによって日本の従業員は企業の言うことをしっかりと聞く、そのことによって一律な人材として働くと自分の立場が良くなるというような形で、非常に一律化した従業員を作ることに日本の企業は成功したということが言えます。
Thus, during that timeThe company employees that would succeed are the ones that are obedient or faithful to the companies, and that if they become homogeneous as much as possible, and then that turn out to be better treatment or promotion by the companies. And as a result, the Japanese economies or companies successfully created such homogeneous workforce.
ですが、そういった時代が昨年一つの終わりを迎えたような象徴的な出来事がありました。
However, that era was completely behind us, as is indicated by the development that we saw last year.
飲食チェーン店で、ストを起こされて、そのまま閉店に、陥ったようなニュースを皆さんもご覧になったと思いますが、かつてであれば、ストを従業員に起こされても、いくらでも代わりが効くんだというようなやり方を日本はしてきましたが、昨年のアベノミクス効果で一気に近隣の店舗も忙しい、またオリンピックの受注によって日雇いの労働者も建設の仕事があるということで、従業員は代わりが効かない存在というような形、非常に労働力不足という特徴が一気に上がってきたということが言えます。
You might remember the report where some, the large size restaurant chain, they had to close their restaurants because of the strike by the employees. Well, in the past, even when the employees resort to the labor strike, labor strife, the companies could simply fire them because they were kind of expendable, so to speak, replaced easily. However, as a result of Abenomics, the economy started to boom and therefore improve at least, and therefore the restaurants around that the particular store also became very busy, and at the same time, due to the Olympic hosting, more demand for labor force, for construction, and so on. And therefore, Japan started to see the shortage of the labor.
こうした背景から日本は一気に人材奪い合い時代というような状態に今突入しました。
As a result, the Japanese companies are now the fighting over limited size of the pie, which is the human resources.
そうなると下に挙げた人口オーナス期に発展しやすい働き方の特徴が強く出てきます。
And that's when the working style that is more suited for the population owners period would be highlighted.
まず男女を徹底的にフル活用、どちらも活用できなければならない。その上で現在労働力は足りませんので、その中学生、女子学生であった、女子学生たちが企業を選ぶかどうか、つまりその女性に選ばれる企業であるかどうかというようなことをきちんと表さなくてはならなくなりました。
First, the companies now have to fully utilize the workforce, whether they are men or women, due to the labor shortage. Therefore, and at the same time, therefore, the companies have to now demonstrateThemselves that they are the ones that could can offer the environment better for women, and they have to demonstrate that to those the students and the senior of universities and the schools.
その上で重要な法案が昨日、参議院を通過しました。女性活躍推進法案というものです。
And then the other day, the important bill.Was adopted at the upper house of the parliament. That is about the bill to promote the active development of women.
これは来年の春から施行されるんですけれども、そうすると301人以上の企業は自社の男女の比率、女性の管理職の率、それから離職率の男女の差、それから女性役員がいるかどうか。残業の平均時間というようなものをすべてオープンにしなくてはならなくなります。
And this law would be implemented in spring next year. And under this law, according to the requirements, the companies that employ 301 or more employees have to disclose the following: the number of men and women employees.How many women management are there? What about the attrition between men versus women? Whether there are women directors and what about the overtime, average overtime working hours for men and women?
また2点目になるべく短時間で働かせるという企業が勝ちます。これは時間あたりの費用が高騰することで、長時間働かせるとそれが大きなコストとなるからです。
And also another winning secret for the companies would be to let their workforce work for shorter hours. That is because of the rising cost per hour of a work. Because of that,If the employees have to work for many hours, then that would result in increasing cost.
こうした中で男性が親の介護で短時間勤務になるというような事象が建設会社や商社といった今まで日本社会では男性が9割以上を占めてきたような企業で大きな問題となり、私たちの会社への問い合わせもそういった男性中心型の企業からの問い合わせが今急増しているという状態です。
As a result, in those business segments that are typically dominated by men, such as trading houses and construction companies, they are now seeing the need for the middle-aged, the middle management men that have to take a leave for a nursing need of their elderly parents. And in fact, those are the business segments that used to be the represented 90% by men, and yet we are seeing increasing inquiries from and requests for consulting from those businesses.
そして3つ目の条件がなるべく違う、条件の人を揃えること、例えば育児や介護や、難病を抱えている方、障害を持っている方といった多様な人材をどれだけ内包できるかです。
The third question has to do with inclusiveness. In other words, how the company or organization can include the diversity of different conditions of employees, such as those that have a need for childcare, the nursing need,or the people that have refractory diseases, or the handicaps yet willing to work.
私から見て、日本の企業は極端な男尊女卑で、女性を排除しているというよりは、働き方によって、24時間型の男性しか活躍できないということをずっとやってきました。
From my point of view, Japanese companies were not male chauvinistic companies to begin with.Rather, the male had to be the predominant workforce for those companies because what was required by those companies are the ones that can work around the clock.
今まで、出張や転勤や残業というものを課していたのを、その条件を変えることによって、いろいろな障害を今までは持っていた人たちを全部労働市場の中にもっと招き入れていこうというようなところに変化をしてきています。
So instead of imposing different conditions like the moving to other locations or the business trips or overtime work, by changing those conditions, they can include the more people with different conditions as a part of their workforce. And that's how the labor market is changing.
こうした変化を図に、例えるとこんな感じで、今までは左側にあるような人口ボーナス山にしがみついていた日本が、今右側にあるボーナス山に飛び移ろうとしているというような形です。
And this is the illustration of what I have been describing about. That is Japan and the Japanese companies used to try to stay on the population bonus mountain, so to speak. And they are now trying to jump over and moving toPopulation onus mountain.
タイムリミットが、その飛び移るタイムリミットが2つありまして、1つは先ほど申し上げた介護の問題、団塊世代が一気に、要介護、つまり70代に突入するまでたったあと2年しかありません。
However, there is a time limit of doing that, and there are two important timings. First, there are only 2 years before baby boomers become 70s.Meaning they could be potential candidate for the nursing need.
もう一つのタイムリミットが、団塊ジュニア世代の出産適齢期の終わりです。団塊ジュニア世代というのは団塊世代の、子どもの世代ですけれども、その女性たちが出産適齢期を終えるまであと3年ぐらいと言われています。
And another has to do with the baby boomer juniors. It is stated that there will be three more years before those baby boomer juniors, women, would come to an end of the childbearing age.
これは参考までに入れておいたんですけれども、今の出生率のまま、いくと、2100年時点の日本の人口はなんと現在の4割にまで減少します。
And this is for your information about how the population of Japan would develop or decline if nothing is done. By year 2100, the population of Japan by then would be 40% of what it stands today.
そのこう今後の人口を変える可能性があるのは、団塊ジュニア世代が一番最後のボリュームゾーンなんですけれども、この団塊ジュニア世代がもしも出生率を短期的に上げることができれば、2100年時点で今の7割程度の人口で、しかもその後下げ止まる、均衡フェーズに入るというふうに言われています。
And this could change by the large cohort, the last large cohort that we can expect of, that is the baby boomer juniors. If they can successfully improve the birth rate, then by 2100, the population of Japan would be 70% instead of 40% of the current population. And then the population decline would stop and come to the plateau.
このあと100年200年の日本の人口を変えることができるかどうかはここたった3年にかかっているということが言えます。
That means that we are now coming into the make or break or the major, the moment of the truth, so to speak, which spans for 3 years, and depending on that, we may be able to change the population 100 years or 200 years from now or not.
最後にすでに私たちがコンサルした企業では、労働時間を減らして業績が上がってその企業の女性従業員の産んだ出産数が 1.8 倍になった企業というようなもう事例が好事例が出てきています。
Before conclusion, I'd like to briefly introduce the one of the companies that we offered consulting service. There are cases where the working hours were reduced with the better result of business performanceWith the number of babies born among the women workforce was increased by 1.8 times.
他にも有名なユニクロであったり、トヨタ系のトヨタ通商というような企業ですでに、大きな変革が起きてきていますので、この後ご興味があればご質問いただければと思います。
And in fact, such changes are also seen among leading companies.Like Uniqlo and Toyota Trading House, Toyota Tsusho, the one of the Toyota affiliated companies, among others. If you're interested, I will be happy in answering questions related to those successful companies as well.
すでにワークとライフの負のスパイラルだった日本から、ワークとライフが相乗効果、好循環となる社会への変革が始まっているというふうに思っております。以上です。
Before conclusion, I'd like to state that Japan, out of the negative spiral or the vicious cycle of the work-life balance, is now coming into the virtual cycle or positive the spiral producing synergy effect. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。途中から入られた方のために再度ご案内いたします。本日はご案内の通り、写真撮影の時間をこれから行う質疑応答の冒頭 2,3 分に限らせていただいております。それ以外の時間帯の撮影はお控えいただきますようお願いいたします。また撮影場所も会場後方の左右に限らせていただきますので、ご協力をお願いいたします。
For those of you who came in the middle of the program, I'd like to remind you once again that the photo taking is limited for the first three minutes of this Q&A session. And also, if you wish to take photos, please stand either the right or the left-hand side of the back of the room. Thank you for your cooperation.
それでは質疑応答に入ります。質問は外国プレスの方からお受けし、お一人一問とさせていただきます。質問のある方は挙手をしていただき、指名されたらハンドマイクを使って必ずお名前とご所属を述べてから質問してください。
I'd like to take questions from the foreign press first, and please limit the question just one per person, and please raise your hand if you have any questions and wait forfor the nomination by the MC, and then wait for the microphone, and then identify yourself before stating your question.
どうぞお願いします。
はい、ウォールスイートジャーナルのウォーノクと申します。こんにちは。本日は貴重なお話をいただき本当にありがとうございました。先ほどちょっとお話の中で出てきたんですけれども、女性活躍推進法案について聞きたかったんですが、その法案の中で数字目標があるかと思うんですけれども、それが本当になんていうんですかね、役に立つかどうかっていうのが結構議論されてるんですけれども、それについて小室さんがどういうふうに考えられてるかっていう、はい、ぜひ伺えればと。
Wanok from Wall Street Journal, and thank you for your presentation today. I have a question related to the bill to promote the women's role in in that bill. There are some numerical targets or figures, and there's some argue that they may not be quite useful or as significant as it may appear to be. And could you care to comment on what is your opinion about that?
ご質問ありがとうございます。目標数値を どのように その設定した数値自体を低くするんではないかって、そういう意味ですか。あまり、
あるいはそのライフ・ワーク・ライフ・バランス の環境が実際に変わってない中で、数値を導入すると本当に変わるかどうか。
ありがとうございます。今回の目的はどちらかというと、企業は一社ごとに、自分たちの現状とそこから考えた目標数値というのを掲げることをお願いしているんですが、一番の短期的な目標は現状をオープンにさせることによって、今までだとネームバリューでほとんど騙して騙してと言ったら言い過ぎですが、女子学生を採用することができてしまった、また学生を使い捨てするようなことができてしまった状態から、ほとんどの学生は面接官の感じの良さとか、ホームページだとかっていうもので騙されてきたんですが、実際に入社して10年20年経って離職率がどうなのかというような長期的な視点で企業が選べるような市場にしてしまう。で、人材奪い合い時代に入っていますので、そこの市場でオープンになってしまうことによる、淘汰の、機能というのをしっかり果たしていくというのが第一目的ではあります。
Well, the first asking for the qualification, whether theYou're asking that such numerical target could be set extremely low. Well, that's part of that, but also the main gist of the question is that when the work-life balance related environment is not improving as such, then whether the numerical target can really change the situation or not. Now coming to the answer, well, in fact, each company is not required to set first of all, to state where they stand, the reality, as well as the target, the goal. But in the short run, what we expect from them is to, first of all, to disclose where they stand, the reality. Because for many years, the companies that had a good appearance, so to speak, with the brand name, so to speak, or the famous names of the companies, they successfully attracted the students, including women, and then eventually they were replaced by new employees. They were considered as expendable. However, now and in the past, the women, the students also tend to choose companies based upon the impression during the interview or based upon the impression of the website. But now we want to change the situation where they rather look at attrition in 10 years or 20 years after they join the company, and depending on that, they should make a better choice. And nowadays, as we are seeing increasing competition among companies over workforce, this kind of information could be crucial for them to attract better quality people.
特に制度ではなく、育児休業制度や短時間勤務制度ではなく、残業時間や離職率の差というようなものを、数値に掲げているというところが最大のポイントだと思います。
And in fact, under this bill, the main focus is not about the system that is established within the company to support child care or the shorter working hours. Rather, they set the requirement about the disclosing the attrition as well as the average overtime working hours and so on.
他にご質問ありますか。
Hey, AFP 通信の西村ポペキャリンと申しますが、今日のお話は出てなかったと思うんですけれども、日本の大企業は海外のに比べるとよく転勤が多いと思いますが、時々その転勤で単身赴任になってしまう状況なんですけれども、それに対する何か意見がありますんでしょうか。
My name is Nishimura Puppe from AFP, and I have a question about what was not included in the presentation. In the case of the leading Japanese companies compared to the rest of the world, the peers of the rest of the world, it appears that employees have to relocate or the move to different locations for the work. And in many instances, either one of the parents that would choose to move, so that the typically the husband or father would be relocated. And what can you say about that?
ありがとうございます。日本のその転勤の最大のこう特徴はいつまでという終わりを約束されない転勤であるということなんですね。他の国でも転勤自体が全くないわけではありませんが、日本の場合はまず辞令1枚で、本人が最初に契約の中に、全くこう決めていないようなところにでも簡単に転勤させられてしまうことと、終わりを決めていればほとんどの場合は子どもの教育の問題が一番中心になると思うんですが、受験にかぶってしまうかぶってしまわないというようなことを判断して一緒に行くこともできるわけですが、終わりが約束されないというのが日本の企業の特徴なので、連れていくことが大きなこうリスクとなって単身赴任になってしまうというケースがあります。まずは、
Well, the a major problem that has to do with the relocation in the case of the Japanese company employees is thatthere is no time limit that is the promise or committed. In fact, relocating employees to different locations of their operation can be seen in their peers in the rest of the world. However, in the case of Japan, they would just get one letter indicating that they have to now start working for the affiliated organization in different location. And sometimes such a letter indicates the locationwhich was not included in the original contract that the employees committed to. And for those employees that have to relocate their operation, if the deadline is indicated, then they can decide whether to bring with them the family members, because in most instances that has to do with the education need.And yet, when it is not committed, and if deadline is not shown, then because of the risk, they choose to move alone.
すでにですね、変化が出てきていまして、カルビーさん、お菓子の会社のカルビーさんなんかは今、転勤拒否権を従業員に与えるということを始めました。で、転勤拒否をした人間を人事的に不利益に必ずしないということの約束もしています。またある商社さんなんかでは、海外に転勤をさせる事例を出すと、事例を出す前に内々の打診をすると、1人動かすのに9人ぐらい今打診をしないと、介護の問題で動けない人が非常に増えてきていて、この転勤で人を動かしていくシステムということ自体を相当見直さなくてはならないというフェーズに来ているかと思います。
And here again, we are seeing some changes. For instance, in the case of the confectionery or snack manufacturer Calbee, they now give the veto, the right to turn down the request for relocation to employees. And even when they decline the offer, they will not be treated in any way advantageous compared to the rest of the peers. And that's one example.And also, there is another development, that is to say, in the case of trading companies, when they need to relocate one of the employees to overseas operations, they typically have to consult with at least 9 employees to find out the best candidate, because many of them have the need for nursing or taking care of their elderly as well. Therefore, they are unwilling to move. And therefore, they now have to...The reconsider or restructure the system of their operation rather than simply relying on employees that will be relocated.
Siegfried Little from Germany, from writing for Austrian newspaper, The Standard. You didn't talk about part-time.Working, but I think I mean part time, not as a irregular kind of working. I mean as a regular type of a working contract. Perhaps in my countries, employees can ask their employer for to working only 3 or 4 days. Some of my friends do it. What about this opportunity in Japan? And the other problem, if people don't want to make work longer, work hours, what does it mean for a career chance? Do they have a less career chance? Is it not good for their career to work not so much?
パートタイムに関して触れられなかったと思うんですが、まあ、いわゆる非正規雇用というような形で、捉えられている人たちがいるかと思いますけれども、我が国においてドイツなんですけれども、私の国ではその従業員の方がその、雇用者に対して私は週3日から4日しか働きたくないというようなそういったことを申し出ることができると。で、実際そういうことを、実行している人たちもいるんですが、こういった面はどういった、まあ、可能性あるいは機会が出てきているんでしょうか。それからもし長時間労働を拒否した場合に、その人にとってキャリアの面での何か影響はあるんでしょうか。そのキャリア上それは良くないとか、あるいはその長時間働くということがそのキャリアにとって良くないとか、そのキャリアに対する影響ということではどうなんでしょうか。
ご質問ありがとうございます。1点目 の、 その、パートタイムまたはジョブシェアリングというような考え方についてかと思うんですけれども、日本で今までそういったことがうまくできなかったのは、仕事の属人化、その人にしか知らない仕事があるというような状態で、仕事をするのが、まあ、ほとんどの職場であり、一つの大きな、仕事を他の人と一緒にやるというようなことが非常にできにくいというような小習慣があり、今これを非常に改善する、これを変えていかないと、ワークシェアリングができないというようなことがちょうど今改善されているような企業が出てきています。
Thank you for your questions. And about the first part of the question, that is about the part-time or the job sharing, I would rephrase it. And in Japan, the job sharing did not work so far. That is because within the organizations, a particular piece of work used to belong to one particular employee, and that person alone knew how to do that particular piece of work. And therefore, it was not shared by other colleagues or peers, and therefore the work sharing was not possible. However, here again, we are now seeing some changes and improvement being made.
2つ目 の、 長時間労働ができないとどうなるかという問題なんですが、これは非常にどういう評価の仕方を日本がしているかということと密接になっています。
And the second part of the question has to do with the relationship between the long working hours or declining it with the career development. And it is closely related to the question of how the quality of the employees or how employees are appraised or evaluated within the organizations.
これはシカゴ大学の山口教授が、もう、言っていることなんですけれども、日本の評価は、月末や年度末で締めたときに引っ掛ける量がどれだけ高かったかという勝負をさせる評価、でこれは年末、まあ、1日あたりの労働時間をどれだけ最大化して、残業をたくさんすれば高い評価がつくというような形になります。一方で労働時間に上限がある国、日本は法律できちんと上限が決まっていないわけなんですが、まあ、正確に言うと決まっているけれども機能していないんですが、他国の場合は労働時間の上限があります。で、上限があれば時間あたりの生産性で評価をされる。この期間あたりの生産性なのか時間あたりの生産性なのかというのが、日本は大変特殊な期間あたりの生産性で評価されるので、長時間労働をやってどれだけ山を高く積んでいくかというような勝負をさせられているという特徴があります。
And according to Professor Yamaguchi of Chicago University, in Japan, the how evaluation is done for the employees is as follows. You look at the result at the end of the month or at the end of the fiscal year, and then look at the amount of work that was achieved. And therefore, those employees that worked the longest hours per day would eventually tend to get higher evaluation.And in terms of the ceiling or limit for the working hours, in fact, it is provided for under the law in Japan, but it's not functioning. While as in other countries, such ceiling is established there so that they look at the productivity per unit, the working hour or the per hour, instead of the productivity for a certain period of time. That is a major the difference compared to the rest of the world. Therefore, in Japan, the companies tended to evaluate employees' performances based upon how high the mountain was accumulated by working many hours.
先ほど少し事例で紹介したこのリクルートスタッフィングという会社が何をやったかというと、それまでは、最優秀賞を取るためには期間あたりの生産性で、チームが1位にならなきゃいけなかったんですが、この、ブルージャケット賞という最優秀組織賞は労働時間がある一定の枠内のチームしか受賞できないというふうに設定したんです。こうしたその時間あたり生産性の評価軸に変えたというのが一番大きな変化をもたらして、先ほどのような、生産性が向上して、労働時間が減って出生率が上がったというようなことが起きました。
And I briefly introduced the one case study of the recruit staffing. In that case, what did they do? Well, in the past, the number one team that won the prize as the best the performer was the team that accomplished the best result for a certain period of time. Now, they are to be evaluated under the different system, that is a Blue Jacket Award. And under this system,The teams that are qualified for that competition are the ones that worked within the limited working hours. So, in other words, they are now looking at the productivity per hour rather than the certain hours. And therefore, with that, they achieved the shorter working hours, higher productivity, higher revenue with higher birth rate.
その他ご質問いかがでしょうか。
David Sabon with Radio Canada. She mentioned that there is a few years horizon for Japanese company to transform the way they behave. How ready are the companies right now to do those changes?
先ほどおっしゃったかと思うんですが、日本企業がこの変化を遂げていくためには、数年まだ時間かかるというようなそのことがあったかと思うんですけれども、日本企業がその行動を変えていくのに、どの程度今その体制が整ってきているんでしょうか。どれくらい変わろうとしているんでしょうか。どれくらい準備ができているか。
そうですね、一番大きなキーとなっているのは経済団体だと思います。これは明らかに今までは労働時間の管理をしなくてもいい法律を作れということをこう政府にずっと言ってきました。でその潮目がですね、今大きく変わって、経済団体が、むしろ先ほどの女性活躍推進法案を競って行動計画を書くというような状況になってきています。で日本の企業は大変ピアプレッシャーに弱いので、一つのこう節目が変わると一気に進むということが考えられるので、どれぐらい整っているかというのは難しいんですが、急速に動く可能性があ
るなというふうに感じています。 Well, I believe key would be the business associations, the associations that many companies belongTo that is to say, in the past, those business associations used to call for the laws that would not require the time control, the working hours control to the government. But now we are seeing a kind of sea change, and that the under the such the business associations, they are now trying to come up with the action plan under the law that I mentioned earlier about promotion of women.And in Japan, the companies are they're quite susceptible to the peer pressure, and therefore, if there is one piece of change or one company changes, then all of a sudden, the rest of the pack would follow. And therefore, to answer the question directly as to how much they are ready, it's hard to answer. But there is a possibility that there will be the very quick or rapid change.
政府の方の読みとしては今、失った支持率を回復しなきゃいけない、 というようなところがあり、まあ、特に母親層、女性層を、まあ、支持率として失っているというところがあるので、それを回復できる、まあ、トピックというとなかなか他にない、こういった労働時間のことというのは、支持率を回復していく上で非常に重要なあの政策というふうに捉えられるのではないかな、力を入れられるのではないかなというふうに思っております。
And also, there is some factor related to the government as well. They are now seeing declining job approval rate, and therefore, in order to improve that, they turn to women, especially mothers, to give them their support. And in order to win their support, the topic that is conducive to women and mothers would be, for instance, shorter working hours, and therefore,Now the government views that this is an important piece of their policies in gaining the support from the women and mothers.
Hello, my name is Camille from the Embassy of Lithuania.
Excuse me, are you a press?
Yes.
Are you a press?
I am, yes. I wanted to ask, the situation has become a bit of a culturally accepted.And do you face any reluctance from the workers themselves? And how do you deal with it? Thank you.
The reluctance of what?
Of changing working hours, of reducing them, flexible working, things like that. Thank you.
文化的な面での その重要性ということに関連してなんですが、その、まあ、従業員、まあ、あるいはその労働者の方で、働く人たちの方で、その労働時間の短縮をしたくない。あるいはそういった柔軟な働き方はちょっとあまりしたくないという、そういったその、まあ、拒否といいますか、従業員の側の態度という、それを拒むような態度というのはないんでしょうか。
あります。で、非常に面白い例があるんですけれども、SCSK さんという IT の企業さんです。で、上から6個目のところに書いてあるんですけれども、この SCSK という会社さんは、社長の意識が先に変革をし、従業員に残業を減らしなさいということを言ったにもかかわらず、仕事があるからやっているんだからということで、全く減らなかったというのが当初の2年ぐらいでした。
Yes, there is reluctance, and there is one interesting example that has to do with the IT company SCSK, their number 6 in the list. And in that case, it was the president that changedthe mindset and awareness, and therefore he turned to employees asking them to work less hours. But then employees rejected, saying that they have a job to do, that's why they are working that many hours. And that situation lasted for about 2 years.
ただその企業で、やった取り組みというのが、では業績が落ちないで残業時間が減ったら、それで浮いたコストを皆さんに還元しましょうと。でその還元するルールは、前年よりも 20% 以上減ればゴールドランク、 10% 以上ならシルバーランクというふうに、前年よりもより多く減らした部署にたくさん還元しますというようなルールを取り組んだ瞬間にものすごく減ったんです。
And therefore he introduced the program, and he said, what if the company performance improved with less overtime work, and then there will be the cost saved, and then that saved cost would be returned back to the division or department, the team that contributed most. And if your team saved 20% of the cost, then you will be the qualified as gold prize, and a 10% reduction would be the silver prize. And all of a sudden, when that rule was introduced, thenThe employees started to work less hours.
私が思うのは、決して日本人は仕事がどうしても絶対やりたいのではなくて、インセンティブの設計が間違えている。どういう人が褒められるのか、どういう人が得をするのかという設計をずっと間違えてきたので、そちらに動かなかっただけで、そこの設計をきちんとすればいくらでも働き方は変わる。この企業さんの場合は 40% 以上残業が削減できて、日経新聞の働きやすい企業ランキングの1位を昨年は獲得しています。
And, in my opinion, according to the Japanese, the culture or the nature of the Japanese peopleI don't think Japanese people definitely want to work at all costs. Rather, the incentive given to the people was designed poorly so that the those people that would gain or those people that would be evaluated appraised highly, the way the system was designed was wrong and therefore it didn't work in the past. But now that such incentive the system is redesigned, so to speak, now we are seeing some changes and improvement. And in fact, the company that I just introduced, in their case, they reduced overtime job by 40% and therefore they were chosen as the best company, the company with the best environment offered to the employees according to Nikkei.
それではこれで時間になりましたのであと1問お受けしたいと思います。どうぞ。
The time is running out, therefore this will be the last question.
台湾連合法のライと申しますが、残業代ゼロという法案は本当に長時間労働を減らせますか？この法案についてどう評価していますか？
Right from Taiwan, whether the new law to eliminate overtime work, whether that would actually work and it can really reduce or eliminate overtime work, and what is your view on this the law?
その法案は今国会ではもうおそらく通過しないということが、おそらくというかもう通過させることを見送りということになりましたが、私はその法案に非常に反対でした。でというのも先ほどのような、労働時間が長くできる人にその人にどんどんと仕事を乗っけて、その人に甘えていくような日本の職場の中で労働時間管理をしない人を作れば当然、そこに、どんどんどんどん上司は仕事を乗せていくという方法を取るのが、日本社会においては、導入した場合の、結果であるというふうに私はこれは政府にも申し上げました。決してその、労働時間を管理しない方向、残業代ゼロというような方向に行けば、みんなが柔軟に働くというようなことは起きないというふうにですね、これは私の、主張ですけれどもということを申し上げて、まずは短い時間の中で成果が上げられる仕組みを作った後に柔軟に働ける仕組みを入れていく、この順番が大事であるということを提言していました。
Well, that bill that you have just mentioned, has no chance of passing the current Diet session, and in fact, the government, gave up, the passing or enactment of that bill, and, actually, I voiced opposition to that bill. The reason is because in Japan, the typically those people that could work long hours tended to be relied on more, and therefore those employees ended up with assuming more and more burden. And therefore, if such a law is enacted, where the employees without the working hours the control would be established as a kind of a category, then.The companies, the Japanese companies are likely to place more burden onto those people that can work many hours, and therefore this would not change or improve the situation, and this would not result in the flexible working style. That was my opinion, and therefore I voiced that opposition to the government as well. Therefore, I rather consider that we have to change the structure or scheme to evaluateThe result achieved in the shorter period of time, and then move on to flexible working style. Therefore, that has to be the sequence to move on.
それではこれでブリーフィングを終了したいと思います。本日は小室さんどうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。This concludes the briefing session. Thank you very much, Ms. Komuro.